This is here I think connect Maven and salesman play their most important role in the chapter on the role of the few. I talked about how their special social gift can cause epidemics to tip. Here though, it's possible to much more specific about what they do. They are the ones who made it possible for connect innovation to overcome this problem of the chasm. They are translators. They talk ideas and information from highly specialized world and translate them into a language the rest of us can understand. Mark Alpin, University of Texas professor who I described as a maven, is the kind of person who would come over to your house and show you how to install or fix or manipulate a very complicated piece of software. Tom Gao, the quintessential salesman, takes the very aching field of tax law and retirement planning and repackaging in terms that make emotional sense to his client. Luis Westberg, the connector, because belongs to many different world: politics, drama, environmentalism, music, law, medicine, and on. And one of the key things she does is to play an intermediary between different social world. One of the key figure at Rameses was D.D. Gordon, the firm's former head of market research. And she says that the same process occur in the case of the fashion trend that periodically sweep through youth culture. So innovators try something new, then summon the teen equivalent of the maven of a connector of a salesman sees it and adopt it. Those kids make things more palatable for mainstream people. They see what the really wired kids are doing, and they tweak it. They start doing it themselves, but they change it a bit. They make it more useful. Maybe that's a kid who rolls his jeans and puts duct tape around the bottom because he's the one bike messenger in the school. Well, the translator like that look. But they want to use tape. They'll buy something with Velcro. Well, then there was the whole baby doll t-shirt things. One girl starts wearing a shrunken down t-shirt. She goes to Toys R Us and buy a Barbie t-shirt. And the other says, "That's so cool," but they might not get it. So small, and they might not get it, either Barbie or Neil. They look at it and say it's a little awful, but they away, I can change it, make it okay. Then it takes off. Perhaps the most sophisticated analysis of this process of translation comes from the study of rumors, which are obviously the most contagious of all social messages. In his book of Psychology of Rumor, the sociologist Gordon Alport writes a rumor involving a Chinese teacher who was traveling through Maine on vacation in the summer of 1945, shortly before Japan's surrender to the Allies at the end of World War II. The teacher was carrying a guidebook which said that a splendid view of the surrounding countryside could be seen from a certain local hilltop, and he stopped in a small town to ask direction. From the innocent request, a rumor quickly spread. A Japanese spy had gone up to the hill to take pictures of the region. The simple unadorned fact that constitute the kernel of truth in this rumor. Allport, right, were from the outset distorted in three directions. First of all, the story is leveled. All kinds of detail that are essential for understanding the true meaning of the incident were left out. There was no mention. Apart point out of the courteous and timid approach of the visitor to the native of the home. He inquired his way. The fact that the visitor's precise nationality was unknown, the fact that the visitor had allowed himself to be readily identified by people along the way. Then the story was sharpened. The details that remained were made more specific. Woman became a spy. Someone who looked Asian became Japanese. Sightseeing became espionage. The guidebook of the teacher hand became a camera. Finally, a process of assimilation took place. A story was changed, so it made more sense to spreading the rumor. A Chinese teacher on a holiday was a concept that could not arise in the minds of most farmer poor. They did not know that some American universities employ Chinese scholars on their stops. On the these scholars, like other teachers, are entitled to summer holiday. Alport right. The novel situation was performance assimilated in terms of most available frames of reference. And what were those frames of reference? In 1945, in rural Maine, at a time when virtually every family had a son or relative involved in the war effort, the only way to make sense of a story like that was to feed it into the context of the war. Thus, this ASEAN became Japanese, guide became camera, and sightseeing became espionage. Psychologists have found that this process of distortion is nearly universal in the spread of rumors. Memory epidemics have been done in which subjects are given a story to read or a picture to look at and then asked to return. Intervals of several months reproduce what they had been shown. Invariably, significant leveling occurs. All but a few details are dropped, but certain details are also simultaneously sharpened. In one classic example, subject were given a drawing of a hexagon bisected by three lines with seven equal-sized circles superimposed on top of it. While one typical subject remembered several months later, it was a square bisected by two lines with 38 small circles arrayed around the fringe of the diagram. There was a marked tendency of any picture or story or gravitate in memory toward what was familiar to the subject in his own life, consonant with his own culture, and above all, to what had some special emotional significance for him. All part right. In their effort after meaning, the subject would condense or appeal in so as to achieve a better gestalt, a better closure, a simpler, more significant configuration. This is what is meant by translation. What Mayburn and connectors and salesmen to do to an idea in order to make it contagious is to alter in such a way in extraneous detail dropped and others are exaggerated so that the message itself come to acquire a deeper meaning. If anyone want to start an epidemic, then whether it's a shoes or behavior or piece of software, he or she have to, she or she has to somehow employ connectors, neighbors, or salesmen in the very way. He or she has to find some person or some means to translate the message of the innovators into something the rest of us can understand.